वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर चैप्टर. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट रदरफोर्ड मॉडल ऑफ एन एटम. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट बोस मॉडल ऑफ एन एटम. इन 1913 नील्स बोर, ए डैनिश फिजिस्ट, एक्सप्लेन्ड द कॉसेस ऑफ द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द एटम इन अ डिफरेंट मैनर. द मेन पास्टुलेट्स आर: In atoms, the electron revolve around the nucleus in stationary circular paths called orbits or shells or energy levels. See, in atoms, the electron revolve around the nucleus. So, this is nucleus. Electron revolve around the nucleus in stationary circular paths called orbits or shells or energy levels. While revolving around the nucleus in an orbit, an electron neither loses nor gains energy. So when electron revolves around the nucleus, neither loses nor gains energy. The next postulate is: an electron in a shell can move to a higher or lower energy shell by absorbing or releasing a fixed amount of energy. So when an electron jumps from higher level to lower level or lower level to higher energy shell, it absorbs or releases a fixed amount of energy. The orbits or shells are represented by the letters K, L, M and N shell. So already I told, electron revolve around the nucleus in a stationary circular paths called orbits. These orbits or shells are represented by the letters K, L, M and N shell, or the numbers N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. The orbit closest to the nucleus is the K shell, that is nearest to the nucleus is the K shell, first shell, that is nearest to the nucleus. It has the least amount of energy and the electrons present in it are called K electrons, and so on with the successive cells and their electrons: L shell electrons, M shell electrons, N electrons. So these orbits are associated with fixed amount of energy. So Bohr called them as energy level or energy cells. So these circular orbits are known as energy level or energy shells because they have fixed amount of energy. These orbits are associated with fixed amount of energy, so they are known as energy level or energy cells. Next, limitations of Bohr's model. One main limitation was this model was applicable only to hydrogen and hydrogen-like ions, example helium plus ions, lithium ion, beryllium ion and so on. So it could not be extended to multi-electron nucleus. So this model was applicable only to hydrogen and hydrogen-like ions. Next, discovery of neutrons. In 1932, James Chadwick observed when beryllium was exposed to alpha particles with about the same mass as protons were emitted. So beryllium, Be8, exposed to alpha particles with about the same mass as protons were emitted. So beryllium plus alpha rays gives carbon and neutron. These emitted particles carried no electrical charges, so they were called as neutrons. It is denoted by 0, N, 1. The superscript 1 represents its mass, and subscript 0 represents its electric charge because this particle, neutron, carried no electrical charges. Properties of neutron. This particle was not found to be deflected by any magnetic or electric field, proving that it is electrically neutral. Then its mass is equal to 1.676 into 10 to the power of minus 24 gram, that is 1 atomic mass unit. Next one is characteristics of fundamental particles. The atom is built up of a number of subatomic particles. The three subatomic particles of great importance in understanding the structure of an atom are electrons, protons, and neutrons. So there are three subatomic particles present in an atom. They are electrons, protons, and neutrons. We know that electrons have negative charge, protons have positive charge, and neutrons carried no charges. Let us see the properties of subatomic particles. So electron symbol is minus 1 small e and 0. So here the charge of electron is minus 1. Mass of electron is 1 by 1837 atomic mass unit. Then mass in grams, 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 28 grams. Then next subatomic particle is proton, symbol 1H1. Charge of proton is plus 1, positively charged particle. Then its mass is 1 atomic mass unit. Then gram, mass in gram, 1.6 into 10 power minus 24 grams. Then neutron, symbol 0N1. So it has no charge. Then its mass is 1 atomic mass unit. Then mass in grams, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 24 grams. So always proton and electrons are equal in number in an atom. Electron has negative charge, proton has positive charge. There are two structural parts of an atom, the nucleus and the empty space in which there are imaginary parts called orbits. So atom has nucleus at its center, then these imaginary paths called orbits or shells, energy levels, energy cells. Inside the nucleus of an atom, the protons and neutrons are found. So they are known as nucleons. Protons and neutrons are found in the nucleus of an atom. So they are known as nucleons. Orbits. Orbit is defined as the path by which electrons revolve around the nucleus. So these are orbits. So nearest to the nucleus is the first orbit, that is K shell, then L shell, M shell. So nucleus present its center of an atom. So students, hope you all understood about Bohr's model of an atom and its limitations, discovery of neutrons, then subatomic particles and their properties. Thank you.